والله ايه
الحمد
لو
لله. good
ان
how are
شاء
you؟
الله دول بدو سيه
وانا كده
سلام عبد الله
how
هاي
come
الحمد لله
الحمد
الحمد لله. I think there's no internet. I'm just recording it now. ما شاء الله سبحان الله كيف أمورك تمام
الله
من منك من منك متى تبدأون الخطبة؟ إن شاء الله فلنبدأ معك المكبرات بس شغال لا شغال
منذ أسابيع لم أشتغل.
طيب الله أبشر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه ثم أما بعد أيها الأحبة الأفاضل اعلموا يا رعاكم الله أن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعاذنا الله وإياكم. قال عز من قائل يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we commence by thanking the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Creator, Cherisher, and Nourisher of this universe. And thereafter we convey abundant peace and salutations upon our noble Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Indeed, One of the most auspicious occasions of Islam has departed. The occasions where the good deeds are multiplied. It is an occasion which lasts few days, but its reward is magnificent and tremendous. Yes, we are referring to the occasion of Al-Hajj. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses or introduces Hajj in the Holy Quran, He says, لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ. Let the people witness the benefits. لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ. So that they may witness the benefits. You and I, with the power of the social media, and all the media outlets, those who are feeding the negativities around Hajj, particularly the difficulties, the hardship and the tragedies of Hajj of 2024, one may ask, what are the benefits that attach to Hajj when people are dying in the thousands? Allah says, لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ. Through Hajj, people will reap the benefits. They will not only reap it, but they will witness it. لِيَشْهَدُوا. It will be in front of them, the manafi'. The benefits will be right in front of them. One thing is for you to be told that there are benefits waiting or anticipating, and the other is to witness the benefits. Allah says with regards to Hajj is not something that is doubtful. لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ. Every Hajj shall witness the benefits of Hajj. Yet in this year, we've heard of the hot waves wiping out thousands. As we speak, whether they told the figures are manipulated or not, but it is established that the 2024 Hajj is one of the most difficult ones. Those who were there, they know what I'm talking about. We saw people falling dead in front of us. For a believer looks at it from a different perspective. Passing away in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is it a tragedy? Where is this the ayah, لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ, so that the Hajj should witness the benefits? Is it applicable in the midst of tragedies? In the midst of hot waves, heat that is above 50 degrees? The answer is yes. When you look at the significance and the virtues of Hajj, this alone will answer your questions and remove your doubts. Firstly, through those few days, 5 days, of your obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qualifies you Jannah. Al-Hajj mabrur, laysa lahu jaza'un illa al-Jannah. An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions in the riwayah, the narration of Bukhari and Muslim, an accepted Hajj al-Mabrur, and that requires interpretation. But the Hajj that is acceptable in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, scholars mention what is Hajj mabrur, la rafatha fihi wa la fusuq. The Hajj that is done in the way that is appeasing to Almighty, the reward of it is paradise. Another hadith, man hajja falam yarfud wa lam yafsuq raja ka yawmi waladatu ummuhu, whomsoever delivers Hajj to its maximum returns back home sinless. Returns home sinless. Another virtue regarding to Arafah. Allah Jalla fi ula draws himself closer to the participants of Arafah. Allahu Akbar. Out of the entire population of earth, Allah chooses to draw himself closer to the people that are present at the field of Arafah, acknowledging the efforts, the hardship, acknowledging the hardship and the tragedies, the inconveniences that they go through, and then he boasts about them. He boasts about them over to the angels. انظروا إلى عبادي أتوني شوذا عورا من كل فج عميق أشهدكم يا ملائكتي أني غفرت لكم. He says his angels, look at my servants. And those servants are those who are drowning in sins. They have come to me from every corner of the world. شوذا عورا. They have gone through hardship. And they are here to seek the forgiveness of the Mighty. أشهدكم يا ملائكتي, I make you my witness of my angels. أني غفرت لهم, I have forgiven and pardoned each participant of Arafat, each participant of Arafat. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم further mentions, يغفر للحاج ولمن استغفر له الحاج. The only guarantee that you have, the only ibadah that qualifies you instant and immediate forgiveness, not only on your behalf, but on the behalf of those whom you seek forgiveness on their behalf. You as an individual are forgiven, and everyone that you seek forgiveness on their behalf, they are also forgiven. Your forgiveness is guaranteed, and you have 1,000 lists of names, 1,000,000, bring a list, seek the forgiveness on the behalf. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that that forgiveness is also guaranteed. It's never the quantity, it's the quality. Badr only lasted 3 days. Badr lasted 3 days, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recorded the names of the participants of Badr, 313 of them, as the cream of this ummah. The cream of this ummah. Uhud lasted 6 days. The participants of Uhud are celebrated, and so on and so forth. Here, the Hujjaj are celebrated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's not it. You go and perform tawaf for every step that you take. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, as you accumulate around the Kaaba, one step raises out your sins, wipes out your sins, and the other alleviates your ranks in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's not it, my dear brothers and sisters. You go and you make istilam at the Yemeni corner. You go and touch the Yemeni corner. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Al-Hajar wal-Rukun yuhuttani al-Khataya huttan. Just by merely touching the Yemeni corner, your sins are also forgiven. When you go and you have the privilege to go and kiss the black stone, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says on Judgment Day, the black stone shall be granted two eyes. Hadith Sahih Sahih al-Albani, it will be granted two eyes, and it will be granted a tongue, and it will intercede on behalf of the person that came and kissed it. Bihaqqiha, bihaq, bihaq, that person that came and kissed it with justice, not to show off. Given all this reward, can a person ever doubt the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the manafi' liyashhadu manafi' lahum, so that the Hajj can go through trouble, hardship, tragedies, to go and present themselves before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reap out the reward. What the media's social media are doing and the social media outlets are doing is to cast fear in the hearts of people. I've heard some people posting, I am reconsidering doing my Hajj because some report shows that for the next 5 years, Saudi Arabia is going to be hit by hot wave. So why must I go through hardship? I ask you the same question. When you had an intense heat in Australia, 2019 to 2020, that resulted to bushfires, I know some of our colleagues, friends, mashallah, from the community went through, hectic. They had to vacate the houses because some of the houses were caught on fire too. Was that not breaking news?
Was that not breaking news? Did we see anyone exiting and fleeing away from Australia because the heat was unbearable? When it comes to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they want to cast doubt in our hearts. إنما ذلكم الشيطان يخوف أولياءه فلا تخافوهم وخافون إن كنتم مؤمنين. Allah speaks about those who came and casted doubts, fear in the heart of the believers on the way to Badr. إن الناس قد اجتمعوا لكم فاخشوهم. They say, look, there is a huge army of Abu Sufyan and the Quraysh. It is an army of 1,000 plus. You are only 300, you're not even half of the population and the number of that army. How are you going to confront them? إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَدَّمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ صَفِيَا. And they're telling you now, flee away from Hajj. I better delay my Hajj to a time when the weather is cooler. What guarantee do you have that you have another 5 years to live? Sahaba said, this time, the iman of the Sahaba increased and enhanced. Allah is sufficient for us, and enough is Allah is a helper and a protector. And Allah further says, now we want to tell you who that person was. They came to you in the form of a social media. They came to you in a form of news or report. No. إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ. What you are reading about hot waves, this is only devilish thoughts. They want to cast doubt in your mind, doubt in your aqidah. What Allah says, لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ. Through Hajj, people will reap out benefits. We are seeing thousands of people dying. إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ. This is only the devilish tricks. يُخَوِّفُ أَوْلِيَاءَ. The only person that trembles and is shaken away by this is the one that entertains the tricks of shaitan. Only the person that has befriended the devil will be the one that will be terrified and traumatized of everything that is happening. If you look at it, Hajj is a form of jihad. Hadith Sahih Aisha radiallahu anha came to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she says, O Messenger of Allah, we have observed that Hajj is one of the greatest forms of worship in Islam. She said that we have witnessed that jihad is one of the greatest forms of something that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is like one of the greatest form of ibadah in Islam. Afala mujahid, as females, should we not go and participate in jihad? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, no. I will lead you to something better than that. I will lead you to something better than that. And this refers to the sisters. And he says, alayhi salam, that the jihad for the females is the one that this had nothing to do with fighting, and that is al-hajj wal-umrah. By going for hajj or going for umrah, that is a form of jihad for the females. Another hadith, hajj mabrur, the hajj that is attached with hardship, discipline, that is a form of jihad. And jihad, lughatan, jihad, when you look at it from a linguistic point of view, it means going through struggle. Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا. Those who go through struggles and hardship for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. They are the ones that Allah will give them divine guidance and light. So jihad means to go through struggle and hardship. You can never undertake jihad while in your comfort zones. You are driving in your ACs. You are, mashallah, sitting in your offices, five-star hotels, Majarul Kabsh. Those who went for Hajj don't know what Majarul Kabsh is. One of the most prestigious package. It's a camp that has got everything close to the Jamarat and everything. Nothing wrong with it. But Hajj, it is something that has to do with your struggle.
Was it easy for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to leave Medina? But of course, he mounted Aswa, his favorite she camel, all the way to Makkah. Was it easy for him? Wasn't he exposed to the same sun? Is it a different horizon? Is it a, maybe you can say there's a climate change and global warming today. But if you ask them, if you ask the Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum ajma'in, they would delay Dhuhr Salah because of the same heat. Salah was delayed because of the same heat. But at this time, they're exposed to the same heat. Yes, people might pass away. And we have no control over that. It is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ayyub radiallahu anhu, Abi Ayyub radiallahu anhu mentions that in the Hajj of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a man capsized, fell along with his camel, capsized with the camel, way at Arafah. And is this not an accident? It is an accident. What happened to this individual? This Sahabi dies, passes away on a spot. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam declares the honor of this individual. The honor of this individual. When you are preparing his body, make sure you abstain away from perfume. Why? Because a person in a state of ihram is not allowed to touch perfume. So he is considered, even though he is no longer in existence, he is still considered to be a Muharrim. فَإِنَّهُ يُبْعَثُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مُنَبِّيًا. Because on Judgment Day, this individual will be resurrected. Everyone else is traumatized and petrified and scared and terrified for this Hajj who passes away in the state of the Haram. يُبْعَثُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مُنَبِّيًا. He will be resurrected while chanting the glory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Laha Min Hana. Death is inevitable. Death is inevitable. On Uhud, mushrikeen came and wanted to cast doubt in the iman of the believers. Something that is happening today. I'm emphasizing on this topic because I know people will be delaying their Hajj intentionally because of the heat. Can you delay the angel of death? Is it better to pass away at holy places or not? So they came, mushrikeen came and wanted to cast doubt in the hearts of the believers. While on the way to Uhud, they went quickly, الَّذِينَ قَالُوا لِإِخْوَانِهِمْ وَقَعَدُوا لَوْ أَطَاعُونَا مَا قُتِلُوا. Ya Allah. They say, Naya, we have heard. 1,500 people passed away because of the hot waves. We told them not to go. We told them not to participate in the battle of Uhud. They were outnumbered. They did not have enough resources, not military resources. لَوْ أَطَاعُونَا مَا قُتِلُوا. Had they listened to our prediction, weather prediction, had they listened to us, لَوْ أَطَاعُونَا مَا قُتِلُوا. Had they obeyed us, they would not have been killed. The same sentiments it is echoed today. If the Hajjis took precautionary measures, what measures can you take against the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? لَوْ أَطَاعُونَا مَا قُتِلُوا. If the participants of Uhud listened to the mushrikeen, and this is their claim, they would not have been killed, but they went. They went forth and marched forth. They were in their eyes. They said they were a little bit stubborn, so they deserved it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds, قُلْ فَتَرَوْا عَنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ الْمَوْتَ إِن كُنتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Those who love to cast doubt in the heart of the believers, can you repel death from yourselves? How many people are dying in your countries because of reckless driving? Drink and drive? How many people are passing away on Christmas Eve, New Year's Eve, because of negligence? قُلْ فَتَرَوْا عَنْ أَنفُسِكُمُ الْمَوْتَ إِن كُنتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If you claim to be smart,
and that you have all the sophisticated equipment to predict your weather. Next 5 years is going to be hot, so don't go for harsh, cancel the harsh trip. What are you doing? What are you doing to repel death? What are you doing to redirect death away from your communities and your countries? And there are people that are tested. This is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We saw people, those were in high moment. It was something that was obvious. People were bleeding profusely. But we know that the death of every individual is determined by Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ وَيُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثَ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. This one verse, Allah said that I have concealed five knowledge from human being. One of it, a man does not know what will happen to him the next day. You go to the fortune teller. The fortune teller will tell you what happened to you last year, yesterday, or 10 years before. Ask the fortune teller, can you tell me the exact schedule of my tomorrow? How does it look like? Never will it be successful. Why? Because that is the knowledge that is preserved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Neither me, nor you, nor any individual can have the precise knowledge of what is going to happen. Even when they're predicting weather, they say it's weather focused. It's a prediction. No soul knows what will occur tomorrow. No person knows where the deathbed is going to lie. Are you going to pass away in Hajj, outside Hajj? That is the knowledge that is preserved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So people seeing this others way, traumatized, and that is natural. To be traumatized, seeing people passing out in front of you, it's natural, it's a natural instinct. You cannot take it away from a human being. But one thing is for you to have belief in Allah, that if my death is written in this place, I'm prepared to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If this is a form of jihad for the females, so I consider myself to be in a battlefield. And yes, I am, because I've spent my money. I've left my family members behind. I've left everything behind for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is there any other better way of meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than this? But there were others that were shaken, a little bit scared and frightened. And they had this thought, the thought of those people that had weak iman when they were going into jihad. لَوْ كَانَ لَنَا مِنَ الْأَمْرِ شَيْءٌ مَا قُتِلْنَا هُنَا. What can we do to safeguard ourselves? I'm not ready to pass away now. A believer is constantly ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this battle, the battle of Uhud, there were some people that had that entertained the thought. They were not munafiqin or anything, but they were gripped by devilish thoughts. لَوْ كَانَ لَنَا مِنَ الْأَمْرِ شَيْءٌ مَا قُتِلْنَا هُنَا. I think if we had remained on the Jabal al-Rumah, maybe this would not have happened to us. If we had extra layer of armor, maybe this would not have happened to us. The heat was scorching. If probably we had maybe a portable AC, a portable fan, maybe that would have helped us. Allah says, no, no. قُلْ لَوْ كُنْتُمْ فِي بُيُوتِكُمْ لَبَرَزَ الَّذِينَ كُتِبَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقَتْلُ إِلَى مَضَاجِعِهِمْ وَلِيَبْتَلِيَ اللَّهُ مَا فِي صُدُورِكُمْ وَلِيُمَحِّصَ مَا فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. You don't know the wisdom behind 1,500 people passing away in this Hajj. Maybe Allah wants to accept them. Maybe they have a secret between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ لَوْ كُنْتُمْ فِي بُيُوتِكُمْ. Allah says, if death was written for you, even if you are in your forfeited homes, even if you are in your comfort zone in your house, but if death was written for you, you would have optionally, voluntarily left your houses to meet
your death, whatever it was written, it is inevitable. We choose how we want to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We conclude through the hot waves. It is a reminder of us as believers. We remind ourselves of Judgment Day. The sun that we see, my brothers and sisters, this is ayah min ayat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is one of the miracles, the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يخوف بهما يخوف بها كيف يشاء ومن يشاء. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses it to remind those who have inclination towards the akhirah. We remind ourselves of Judgment Day when the sun is going to be brought nearer to our heads. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, تُدْنَ الشَّمْسِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنَ الْغَلَائِقَ عَلَىٰ قَدْرِ الْمِيلِ. It's going to be almost 1.5 kilometers above our heads. And people will be perspiring, and people will be standing literally in the sweat, proportion to the sins. Some of them, the sweat will be up to the ankles, some to the knees, some to the shoulders. Alayhi salam says, وَمِنْهُمْ مَيُّ الْجِبْهُ إِلْجَامَةً. Some of them will literally be drowning in their own sweats. The sweats will be a demonstration of a person's sins in his life. But there are those seven chosen categories of the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah will choose to shade them with divine shade on that day. سَبْعَةٌ يُضِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ تَحْتَ ظِلَّ عَرْشِهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ. Seven categories of people. They are the chosen ones. And we can be one of them, inshallah. You can be one of them if you surrender yourself to the will of Allah, by not allowing those who cast doubts in your faith, those who cast doubts and are making a big issue of people passing away, as if to say that people do not pass away at concerts, at stadiums, and yet you are hosting almost 2 million people. Can you go and question the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah we meet? We're going to look at who are these seven categories of people that will be shaded on Judgment Day. Inshallah, bi'idhni al-mawla, qul ma tasma'un, wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum, wa lit-ta'ib min al-dhanbi kaman la dhanba lah, ud'u Allah yastajib lakum, wa astaghfiruhu, yaghfir lakum. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله. ثم أما بعد، اعلموا يا رعاكم الله أن الله تعالى أمركم بأمر عظيم بدأ بنفسه وثنى بملائكته وثنى بكم أيها الناس. قال تعالى مخبرا وأميرا، إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك، ورضى الله من خلفائه الراشدين الأربعة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الصحابة الصحبيات عنا معهم بكرمك وجودك أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداءنا أعداء الدين. اللهم ربنا خذ بنواصينا إلى البر والتقوى يا أرحم الراحمين. الله ربنا تقبل حج الحجيج يا أرحم الراحمين. الله ربنا تقبل سعيهم واجعلهم من الفائزين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا ربنا تقبل منهم يا أرحم الراحمين. الله ربنا كل إخواننا في أرضك المقدسة، الله ربنا كل إخواننا في غزة وفي فلسطين وفي كل مكان يستضعف فيها عبادك يا رحيم يا ودود. اللهم ربنا لا توفنا إلا وقد حججنا ببيتك الكريم المعظم يا رحم الراحمين. عباد الله رحمني رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهاكم عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم ودعوه يستجب لكم واستغفروه يغفر لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.
أخدم هذا ولا فيه ثاني؟ هذا شغال؟
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.
just ensure that you show them filling the gaps.
Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم واخشوا يوما لا يجزي والد عن ولده ولا مولود هو جاز عن والده شيئا إن وعد الله حق فلا تغرنكم الحياة الدنيا ولا يغرنكم بالله الغرور. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. إن الله عنده علم الساعة وينزل الغيث ويعلم ما في الأرحام وما تدري نفس ماذا تكسب غدا وما تدري نفس بأي أرض تموت إن الله عليم خبير. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
اللهم السلام السلام ورحمة الله. ربنا ما نعطيتنا وطيبنا فلعرضنا خلاص. ليش أنتم خربتم الديار والميكروفونات؟ كيف آخر؟ منا منك منا منك. كيف أمورك؟ ما شاء الله. نحمل الشكوى إليك. سعيد كملي كان معنا. سعيد كملي. رأيته؟ لا والله وددت أن أراه لكن لم يتمكن لي. كان فرصة سعيدة جدا. أيوة. هو الذي نريد أن نستضيفه. دعوا لنا.
كيف صارت الأمور مع المحامي؟
الحمد لله الناس نائمون يا أخي، هذه مشكلة. أنا سافرت والناس ما شاء الله نومي عميق، يستحقون الضرب.
لما قال أبو بكر عندما ارتدوا بعد الموت.
الله.
السلام عليكم.
السلام. I don't know who's younger, you or your son. تقبل الله. سعد. تمام عندك أمور. Your dad is looking younger than you. Look at this.
I shaved my gray hair off. My gray hair. I hide it. Wants to go on Hajj next year.
Masha Allah. Inshallah.
You go every year, Inshallah.
Inshallah. If I'm still motivated.
It might be a bit hot next year, I think. نار
حد نار جهنم الله قلنا رجال لو كانوا يفقهون. Rather did while he's still young. Yeah, did and forget about it.
Because you're actually, if I go next year, I'm planning to go to Riyadh for a week and do climate conditioning.
Well, mashallah.
I have friends in Riyadh. I'll go there for a week and do climate conditioning. Go walk around in the desert.
Mashallah. Good.
Because you can't go from the winter here straight into that.
Yeah, that's
or
why.
I buy a sauna.
That's why we go to Medina first. You get a depth.
I buy a sauna here.
Yeah. Mashallah. Even better.
we
need a special fatwa for it.
No, it's easy. That is special. Sheikh, these khutbas are recorded.
We recorded this one. لا خلينا الآن نجلس
خمس دقائق.
طيب إن شاء الله أكون في ما شاء الله. سلام ورحمة الله لفلسطين، أهل غزة، أهل الفضل. كيف أمورك؟ والله دعونا لغزة والعالم كلها تدعو لهم. آمين إن شاء الله. سلام ورحمة الله. إن شاء الله. الحمد لله.
الله حج مبرور إن شاء الله.
أنت كنت تدعو لموتي كذا. خليه لا يجي إلينا صاحب مشكلة. السلام عليكم.
بدون تعليق شيخنا. الحمد لله على السلامة.
نجد. السلام عليكم.